Hello and welcome to my 2023 plans video, I guess. Plans and goals for the year. We all have plans and goals for the year. We all have resolutions going into the new year. And to be honest with you, this past year, the 2022, was a bit of a weird one for me because although I set all these mighty goals and all of this, I didn't achieve a lot of them. But yet I achieved so much more in other aspects is probably the best way of putting it, in the fact that yes, I didn't hit my 500 subscriber goal, whoop-de-doo, but I grew massively as a name in the community and stuff like that. I've really grown. I've become the host of FMTM, or one of the hosts of FMTM, and one of the faces of it almost at this point. I have become prevalent on the Unbelievable Streams podcast, very much a lot of the time ended up doing the streams and treating that as like my little baby, a lot of the time. And yeah, we that's ended up growing itself this year, hitting its first few milestones. And yeah, I've grown a lot in that aspect, and I've ended up using my Instagram a lot more, and I've ended up using my TikTok and stuff less, just because it takes a bit of extra time to do. Although I would like to do it, and if I can get into a mode of doing it, I really will. But you know, it's a tough one because I don't know, I could never really get into it. And then the short form of content, the shorts and the TikToks that I wanted to produce of doing the little mini clips, it just didn't work for me because I just don't have the time, because I have a life and university and jobs and stuff like that to work around. So until I become full-time or able to pay someone else to do that, it's going to be very hard for me to do it. But yeah, it's been a weird one. So looking forward, I think my goal stays the same, 500 subs, I think, on the channel. I know that isn't a lot, and that isn't me growing a lot. I think 500 is like my mini goal, with 750 being my big goal. Because that would be an absolute massive feat. But I do also finish university this year. I graduate this year. So naturally, looking forwards, that's my big thing for this year. My goals are less YouTube based, and instead from YouTube, it's mainly just enjoying my content, because I do enjoy my content. Don't panic, I do enjoy what I do. But I think not stopped enjoying it, because I didn't. I think I got into emotion and my creative juices have started flowing again, and I'm letting them flow, and I'm planning ahead, so I'm able to do the videos that I want when I want to do them, and nothing comes as a surprise. I've got plans for if series finish quicker, finish slower. I've got plans for very different varied games, so I don't have to worry about the variety of games on my channel. Apart from at Christmas time, where I do a lot of Football Manager. But I mentioned it on Twitch a few times. After this Wheel of Misfortune series, that I might not return to Football Manager this year. For the first ever year, I might not return. And a big reason for that is, quite frankly, I've got busier elsewhere. There's a lot of games that I want to do and try out. And there are a possibility, and it's a high possibility as well by the sounds of the news we're kind of getting out, there's going to be two wrestling games this year. So we're going to end up with WWE 2K23, which is amazing. I think we get the first news of that at the Royal Rumble. And then we might have AEW Fight Forever, and I'll want to play both games. I'll want to actually get my hands on both games and really delve into those on the channel. So I think that's where what's going to replace Football Manager is the better way of putting it. That's probably what's going to replace it, is because my passions and my joy will be elsewhere. And I think I've got to let my joys and my passions flow into all these different projects. And when I get ideas for projects, I'm adding them to my Google Doc full of ideas. So if I'm ever needing a series idea, I can look on there and go, right, what do I want to do? What's really in my head? What's right at the front of my forefront of my brain? What do I want to do? Something that people will be happy to see coming back. And he doesn't know I'm telling you guys this now. Predictions and live streams for the wrestling shows will return this year.
Yes! 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 Yes!
Me and Kai are kind of, in a weird, wacky way, going on a little bit of a farewell tour. And I say farewell tour in inverted commas and stuff like that because we don't know what's going to happen post-uni. We don't know where we're going to end up, how far away from each other we're going to end up. If we end up living near each other, which we suspect, the live streams will possibly continue, but maybe at a lesser rate. So not maybe every single pay-per-view, but maybe all the big ones, he comes back in. But I think the live streams are returning. I want to have this farewell tour with Kai, and we want to enjoy ourselves. We're probably going to drink as well, which will be really enjoyable. Yeah, I think they're going to return from Rumble until Mania. Whether we go beyond Mania is beyond... We don't know. We really don't know, because my full passion for wrestling hasn't fully come back yet. I love the games, but my passion for real life wrestling hasn't fully come back. So there will be content around real life wrestling in that time frame. Whether it stays beyond that, I don't personally know. But that's something that's been in the works for a while. We've been trying to work out how we're going to make it really enjoyable for me and Kai. Because we like doing them together, and we're going to really try and make it a proper thing this year. As for the rest of the year, I think the goals are very similar. I want to get my first few paychecks when it comes to Twitch and stuff. I want to stream more, but the streams won't come until post-uni. A lot of my plans are scuppered because I don't know what's happening post-uni. That's why this year is mainly about graduating, getting my first journalism job, getting my first house or flat away from university. Because that's a big thing. I am yet to not live in a student house for university. It might still be a student house per se, or a house with multiple people in and stuff like that. That will still happen. House shares will still happen. But I think it will be nice to just get that first under my belt of being away from university and having my first place away from university, and probably having to play monthly and stuff like that, like normal everyday people, which is weird. It is so weird to say, but yeah, I think a lot of my goals for this year are mainly coming in my personal life. And I think I spoke about in my thank you 2022 video how much my personal life had developed and how much I developed as a person and become more confident and stuff like that. And I think that's going to reflect in my content. I think it already is reflected in my content, but it's starting to properly reflect in my content. And I think this is where it's also reflecting in the fact that I understand that this year is mainly a personal year. It's not so much about the content and really developing that. Although, I say that, right? I've already been doing collaborations. My Wheel of Misfortune videos have collaborations in them. And my current Universe Mode series with Straight Edge is a collaboration. I'm doing more collaborations. My stuff with Kai is a collaboration. We are doing more. I'm doing more and more with other people. We're trying to get a real community involved into this channel. And a big change on the channel, if you haven't seen it already, visually, we have new logos. We have brand new logos developed by the wonderful Emily, who I'm going to put her stuff in the description down below, so you've got all the links and everything to her stuff. She is bloody brilliant. Just look at her illustrations. They are absolutely exquisite. And my logo just suddenly looks clean. It looks crisp. It looks new. It looks exciting. And to be honest, I'm already getting excited by just the way it looks popping off of the page. I'm noticing it popping off of YouTube. I'm noticing it popping off on Twitter. Off Discord a lot more. It just pops off. It really has this real cool, new and exciting and edgy feel to it that I've never had before. My logo was made on a website literally on the day where I went, I need a logo. Ah, what am I gonna do? Now it actually looks like something really nice, really well developed, and something I can be proud of. So thank you, Emily, for that, because genuinely, it is an incredible logo. And I'm saying an incredible logo, incredible logos, giving me multiple logos to use across multiple platforms, and they all look incredible. And every single one of them I've wanted to use and have used on different platforms. This year is one of real personal development for me, but that does not mean that this channel doesn't keep developing. It will keep developing because of these little things like the logo change. I'm always thinking of ways to develop this channel, and it is going to continually develop past this point. My videos will get better, my editing is already getting better, and I'm hoping you're enjoying the way I edit my videos recently. My Instagram is more active than ever before. My Twitter is more active than ever before. I'm appearing on the podcast more than ever before. I am doing more with the podcast in terms of streaming, etc., than ever before. I'm a part of FMTM and we're hoping to have a bigger year than ever before. You're getting the gist, right? This is going to be a really cool, exciting year, but it doesn't come without you. So please put down in the comments down below what stuff you want to see. It doesn't matter how stupid it sounds. It doesn't matter if it's different to what I usually do. Remember, I do reactions. I do real life content. I do gaming content. You know, I do stuff on my personal life and my journalism. It's all about what content you guys want and what you guys want to see. I pay attention. I do look at the numbers. I do look at what you guys want to watch and what you guys continually watch over the course of multiple episodes. Do put it down in the comments down below of what you want to see, because it does help me out a hell of a lot. But apart from that, make sure to hit that like button. Make sure to comment all those stuff down below. And if you are here and you haven't seen any of my other stuff, number one, what the hell are you doing here? But number two, why the hell haven't you pressed that button yet? Press the bloody button! Press the bloody button already! That's it. Thank you. And I shall see all of you in the next video. See ya! The year of the Bragster.